Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs.
Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, with all your mind and with all your strength.
Praise awaits you, O God in Zion. To you our vows will be fulfilled.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. From the lips of children and infants you have ordained praise.
Let us be thankful and so worship God acceptably, with reverence and with awe.
I will sing of your love and your justice. To you, O Lord, I will sing praise.
May my prayer be set before you like incense, and the lifting of my hands like the evening sacrifice.
After this I looked, and before me was a great multitude that no one could count. Every nation, every tribe, every people, every language, standing before the throne and in front of the Lamb.
we shout hallelujah tonight for all he's done? Come on, lift it up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Truth and the love. Thank you. your perfection. I'm lost in your peace. Your faithfulness sings over me, and your love is the light of my soul. And I lift my eyes to you, Creator of the world, and I stand in awe of you, of your glory, and I live to worship. You are worthy to
There's a light in the darkness that shines, giving hope to all the world, hope to all the world. There's a door that's been opened to all, to a new and living way, a new and living way. Praise the name of Jesus, perfect Redeemer, Star of the morning, yesterday, today. There's a fire that burns in our hearts to see the lost return to the Father, and it's a passion that's not of our own. We have seen it in the Son, in the face of the Son.
Church, you say,
praise the name of Jesus, perfect Redeemer, Star of the morning, yesterday, today, and forever. Jesus the same.
Amen. Do you love Jesus, church? Come on, do you love Jesus?
Love you, Lord. promises we made.
Thank you.
The thing about worship and praise is that praise opens those doors to His courts, and worship acknowledges the almighty presence of the living God in your life.
My name is Audrey. I just got here from Portland, Oregon, and I'm about to go to my audition, and so it's very exciting. I'm a little bit nervous. My heart is racing like nothing else, but it'll be good.
Integrous from your heart.
Sure. Love that stronger, love that cover.
What I thought we'd do this morning is I really felt just a few weeks ago actually that it would be really important for us as a team to have communion together this morning and actually seal something in the spirit for this weekend. And actually more than that, more than this weekend, this is like a great start, but I'm believing for great things over your lives, over your families, over this project, over wherever it finds itself, over the lyrics of every song, over the chords, every note that is played, that it has eternal impact wherever it finds itself, and that your lives would be very loud, full of integrity. And that we really will take up what God is asking us to take up and just trusting us with our little piece of the puzzle, but trusting us with as a team. And so I think it's really significant that we do this together. And but what we're going to do this morning is sing I Will Love, the song that Miriam wrote, and just sing Jesus. You alone are worthy. You alone are holy. And let's just take a moment. And this isn't for anyone but Jesus this morning. Okay, it's all about Jesus. And so why don't we just open our hearts, still your mind. Let the peace of God just rule you right now. Still your mind in Jesus' name. And let's worship our King together. Amen. So I really encourage you to stretch yourself, open yourself up to the Spirit of God this morning. Come on, let me sing.
I will love you.
Jesus and his apostles, they reclined at the table, and he said to them, I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you that I will not eat it again until it finds fulfillment in the kingdom of God. And after taking the cup, he gave thanks, and he said, take this and divide it among you, for I tell you, I will not drink again of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. And he took the bread and he gave thanks. And he broke it and he gave it to them, saying, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same way, he took the cup and he said, this is the cup. It's the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. Do you know that this morning when I was just reading that, in those two sentences when he's talking about the blood, he's talking about the body, there's two words both times that he says in those sentences. The two words are, for you. For you. And I'm overwhelmed yet again, and I pray that you are today, that all that Jesus did, he did for you. And so our lives, we want them to be poured out, hey, as lives that say thank you for all you did for me. Thank you, Father, for all you did for me. And, you know, as we go into this weekend, there's so many expectations on this project. No, but in the end, I don't care about any of that. It just has to be a statement of thank you, a statement of praise, a statement of spirit and truth, worship from people who are enamored by their God, who are just captivated by His magnificence, and who want to say, thank you.
Jesus.